My name is Adam Smith, and my partner Chris Kais and I own and run Urban Lumberjacks of Cleveland, or we're called ULOC. We're able to hire 5 or 6 folks from the community, and we deconstruct houses. And currently we're at 506 Literary here in Cleveland's Tremont neighborhood, one of the oldest houses on the street, and we are disassembling this house. We're taking it apart piece by piece, and we're attempting to recycle as much as we can. After the bones of the house, when people say this house has good bones, it's usually the wood. Some of the yellow pine you can see up in the floor joists above us is incredibly valuable. They don't make wood like this anymore, believe it or not. If you can look up, this whole ceiling right here, which is actually the floor, the second floor, will be lifted off. We'll set it outside, and our employees will take it apart piece by piece, take out the floor joists, and then remove the tongue and groove flooring above it. Sandstone, foundation, the windows, and a lot of the structure, a lot of the timbers, the dimensional lumber, can easily be used, turned right around, and volunteers can use the wood to build greenhouses. Our very first structure with the newly employed guys we got out of Tri-C, we took that apart. That was a two-story, very long structure that had a tremendous amount of sandstone foundation blocks in it. So we set those aside, and they were used then. They were just taken, trucked up, literally blocks up to 101 and Frank, and used as the thermal mass foundation blocks all the way around a newly constructed greenhouse. So the dimensional lumber too we used was set that they could put the acrylic panels on. Hopefully more of these greenhouses will pop up. I know we also want to try to work with the botanical gardens and their greenhouses and growing plots, community gardens they put around the city, and use some of our materials for those as well. There's no formaldehyde in this wood. And it's all old growth, which means nobody's cutting down new larch or these 15-year-old pine groves, corporate pine groves. This is, it's already been here. The carbon footprint then would be, neutral if not negative if you have a super insulated house. And indeed, if you're doing everything you can and putting up photovoltaics and creating wind power to these houses built with old, sustainable, recycled timbers, you might actually be carbon negative, giving back to the community that way. Yeah. It would be wonderful to see more and more greenhouses, outdoor structures, community gardens, built or amended with the materials that we have from these houses. It is kind of a legacy. They've gone from one house to the community. What would be even another great way for the wood, these structures to be used, the foundations block to be used, would be in new houses. That's not going to happen right away. Our economic downturn is still in the middle of it. So what I'd love to be able to do is take the wood out, turn it right around, and build new houses. Super insulated, R40 insulation houses.
Straw bale.
Yeah, straw bale. All the new technology, but using old sustainable methods.
Right.
But we do want to make sure that we're, financially viable here too. We want to keep this going, and the way the city's going to allow us to keep doing this is by maybe not turning much of a profit, but making sure that it's equitable, fiscally responsible for all parties involved. because it's still slightly cheaper to demolish a house and throw everything in the landfill, but that's not sustainable in any sense of the word. This is my 15th structure, and 2 years ago, when we very first started out, different business models and deconstruction methods were very labor intensive. They weren't viable at all. We were spending a lot of money to take down one or two houses. Now we've got it to where we can take this structure down in 5 days for just a small amount over demolition cost. But we're going to be able to take a house down, employ 4 or 5 guys or anybody in the community, and it'll balance out. So we will be able to compete with demolition, traditional demolition. That's what we want.